Hey guys, Trisha Midget here. So I bought another gun. I wanted a big bullet gun. One of my friends, he's got a Mosin Nagant, which shoots the 7.62x54R, which is a little bit bigger than this. Arguably, it's a little longer. And the projectile itself is generally a little bit heavier, but you can get loads for this gun that are, you know, more powerful than the 54R. But regardless, I wanted a gun that had common ammo. So I didn't really want to get like an 8mm, like a Mauser. I was looking at a Mauser for a while, but the ammo for those are a little bit more expensive than for this, and this is more accessible. And what I mean by this is 308. Start with what I got. So I bought the gun for $350 out the door, including tax. These guns retail for what I've seen about $300 to $350. This came with some extras. So the extras that it came with, this bipod here, I do not know what brand this is, but it does attach up front here and it seems really good quality. It's got spring-loaded adjustment pieces, and there's all sorts of adjustment you can do to these. In fact, you can lock it, right? Yeah. So that's a lock, and then unlock. So pretty cool bipod. I'm not sure what brand it is. It is totally unmarked, but I'm guessing between maybe 40 on the low end, probably between $40 and $80 is what this retails for, I would imagine. And then it came with a Tasco scope. Now, it took me a while to figure out the scope and how everything's adjusted, but it seems like the eye relief is up here because when I crank it down, it gets really blurry, and then when I crank it to like 200 or 300, it is very, very clear. Now, it goes from a 6 to 24 magnification, and from what I've seen, the research that I've done, the scope is over $100. And then it's got the scope rings, which are an add-on because the scope does not come with those when you buy them. So I got a decent deal. I didn't get a steal. I could have gotten it for cheaper maybe, but it was for $400 and I offered $350, and they did it out the door for me, including tax, because I used my card, my debit card, which if it's cash, they didn't do tax, but they hooked me up and did $350 out the door. So I appreciate that. And, you know, I'm happy with the gun. I have not got it sighted in, but I have shot it. I've shot, what, 30 rounds through the gun or so? So it does fire in it. I shot a TV up pretty close, and it does seem to hit pretty hard, of course. But I have not gotten to test the actual accuracy and consistency, because the one day I went out and shot it, it was very, very foggy. But let's talk about the ammunition I've shot through it. So these are Federal 180 grain soft points. So these would be good hunting loads, and these are the most powerful 308s you can really buy. 180 grains is a very heavy round for this for 308. You can get down to 140 grains. You can get lighter ammo. This ammo is kind of expensive, but it shoots great. It seems like, again, I haven't really been able to put it to the test, so this gun might not like this ammo. You never know. But it fires, and I've only shot 30 rounds, and every one went bang. So that's what I'm looking at. And I just got this ammo basically to shoot it. I did get some cheaper ammo for plinking. I am going to sight it in with not this ammo, so because the state that I live in, you cannot hunt a deer or a big game with a bolt-action, a high-powered rifle like this. You can only do it with 12-gauge, or there's like a shotgun season, then a muzzleloader season. So it's really dumb. The law that's in my state, and I think the Midwest is kind of like that, but out west you can use big bore rifles like a 308 and shoot whatever you want. The ammo that I picked up that's cheaper is Wolf. Surprise, surprise, I run Wolf ammo through a lot of my guns. I shoot Wolf 9mm out of both of my 9s and 223 out of my AR-15, and the ammo is so cheap. It's good plinking ammo, and honestly, really accurate. Now, I do understand that the steel cased ammo tends to, it's not corrosive. That is a total lie. This is not lacquer coated either, so the coating does not come off in your chamber and gum it up. It doesn't do that. That is completely false. It's non-corrosive, like I said too, so that's false as well. It does, I've heard lots of reports and seen a lot of evidence on how it will, your barrel will wear out faster, so you have to replace it sooner. So like my AR-15, after 15, 20,000 rounds of Wolf, I'll replace it. And that's $100, maybe $150 for a nice barrel. And I saved how much money? Probably $500 worth of ammo if I were to buy, you know, match ammo instead. So the savings is worth it for me, at least for my pistol, my AKV even, because after 30,000, 25,000 rounds, I can just send it to Palmetto State in, like, what, 4 years? Maybe it'll take me to get to that amount and send it back to them and have them replace the barrel for me. Because I don't know that I could do the AK myself, but the AR, I can do that easy. But with this being a bolt-action rifle, maybe I'll shoot 200 rounds a year, maybe, out of this gun. So it's not a gun that I'm going to be shooting a whole lot, so this sort of ammo is totally fine out of it. So the barrel length on this, I think it seems shorter than it really is. I think it's like a 22-inch barrel. I saw it's between a 20 and 24-inch. So this round is definitely picking up speed out of this barrel. Now, this is 308, and 7.62x51 NATO is very similar to 308, and I've seen some videos on it and some information, but from what I hear, you can shoot 7.62x51 out of a 308 gun. So I could buy, you know, 7.62 NATO and throw it in this and shoot it if I wanted to, but you can't shoot 308 in a 7.62x51 gun. Apparently, like a SCAR-H, I don't think you could pop 308 in there because the pressures are different from what I've heard. So we'll talk about the features real quick on the gun. It does have a very heavy butt pad that is rubber. It is Marlin. The bore is absolutely mint. You can take the bolt out and you can look down the barrel and it looks perfect. It looks like somebody shot this maybe 10 times. So I did get a good deal and the bore is in great condition. So I'm confident that it's going to shoot accurately because I've heard people shoot these things out to 300 yards all day long and, you know, strike a man-sized target like every single time. So the stock is made of some sort of plastic or polymer. It's different. It's almost like, I don't know if it's the texture, but it might be some sort of like polycarbonate or some sort of, you know, different mixture or mold. But it's very comfortable. It's pretty light. You know, the rifle with the scope on it can get pretty heavy, and it has a heavy barrel. This is pretty decent sized barrel. But it's a light enough gun for me to carry around for sure. So features, moving forward, we have a safety. Back is safe, forward is fire. We have a downturned bolt handle, which I like. I don't like the straight ones, but the Mosin is like that. But I prefer the downturn, just because you can kind of flip the rifle over. You know, with the straight ones, it'll kind of sit up. It's just kind of different. Some people like it, some people don't. It does have a fire indicator, cock indicator, so you know that it's actually ready to fire. I don't think it has a loaded chamber indicator, unless that little thingy-majigger is supposed to pop out or something. I don't think so. I don't think that's what that is. Anyways, moving on. The bolt handle can come out. You push this button down, you hold it down, and the bolt will come out. The bolt seems to be in great quality, great shape. Seems like it was taken care of. There's no rust that I can see on the bolt, which is nice. It's nice and smooth. I did lubricate it when I got it. And everything seems to be in great shape. Again, I did look down the bore when I got it. And it is in immaculate shape. It really is. I don't know the twist ratio on the barrel. It's got a mount on the top. From what I've seen, the actual rail mount is like $30 or $40. So that would probably be an extra cost. For the actual rail that the scope attaches to, because I think the gun just comes without it. I think I've seen models with built-in sights as well. This one doesn't have that, thank goodness. And that's pretty much it, to be honest. The trigger, from what I've seen, is actually stock. I've seen a couple of these come stock. I don't know if this is like the match gun, but they make... there was two of these at the pawn shop. The other one had a different trigger, and it looked more stock. It's got a safety on it, so it won't fire unless you pull the middle portion. And when you do, it's like a 3-pound pull. It's actually very crisp. Yeah, I love it. It is lighter than my buddy's Mosin, for sure. It's like half as light. Oh, it's nice and smooth. So, 3-pound trigger seems to be a nice trigger, like a match trigger almost. It's nice and smooth, so... seems to do its job. Now, it only holds 4 rounds, which is kind of disappointing. I just decided I'm going to get the FMJ. I don't really see a need to have the soft point, but if I go hunting, I'd probably get the soft point, but at the same time, if I'm in a state where I can actually hunt like big game with this, an FMJ is probably going to take down a deer for sure, or other big game, no problem. Doesn't really need to be a soft point. Got it on safe. I'm just gonna eject these cartridges. Seems nice and smooth. And you can fit five in there if you put one in the chamber. I just did this to make sure that the ammo is gonna cycle, because you never know. And it does. So that's it for the video. I hope you enjoy the shooting. And, yep, I just had to buy another gun. This one's not quite as cool because it's a bolt action. I'm not going to shoot it quite as much. But it's definitely a nice to have a big bullet gun for sure.